Dear viewers, warm greetings. In this video, I'm introducing yet another interesting tool termed as Quizlet. It's useful for remembering and understanding of terms and definitions. It has 8 different gamification ways of learning terms and definitions. Among 7 are self-paced learning tactics. And live is the only one option useful for collaborative learning in a gamification mode. How this tool is helpful? Every learner has their own learning style, their own way of learning. So this tool enables every learner to adapt to their way of learning. It has 7 ways of learning. Each one of us tend to prefer any one of the mode of learning so that everybody will feel comfortable and excited towards learning. Technically, an individual's learning style refers to the preferential way in which the learner observes, processes, comprehends, and retains information. Totally, the power of assimilation is a key for learning anybody's quality. So that now we are moving towards this way of learning with this tool Quizlet. It has 7 different ways of learning, which are all flashcards, learn, test, write, spell, match, gravity, live. Shortly, we will be looking into demonstration of this tool, how it enables, these are all the ways of learning, and how to create a study set. We will be looking at shortly. Keep watching. Thank you. Quizlet is a magical learning tool the new generation teachers must know. 21st teaching learning practices demands incorporation of technology into their TLPE. Quizlet is useful for self-paced learning, helps to learn terminologies, definitions, and facts, allows to label the image with the definitions like body anatomy, parts of architectural diagram, component of a machinery. These all possible to teach through Quizlet in a fun-filled way. Fulfills the needs of different learning styles. Students can learn beyond classroom using their mobile devices as well laptops. Learning or memorizing can be repeated with different gamification techniques such as flashcards, spell, write, learn, test, match, gravity, and life. In general, whenever students tend to learn a new subject, it is mandatory to learn set of terminologies and definitions. Unless otherwise they are thorough on those terms and definitions, it's very difficult to cope up with the subject. For example, heat transfer subject has a lot of terminologies like convection, conduction, radiation, condensation, evaporation, something like that. Unless otherwise a student or a learner knows clear understanding of those terms, only then the entire subject matter becomes easier for learning or for articulation or for writing or for presentation. In every book, if you look at the end of the book, we could able to see glossary of terms that signifies anyone would like to cope up with this book reading, they should be aware of those all terms, definitions, or they should be thorough on such kind of words, keywords to pick up that subject. That is the significance of glossary of terms. So this is the tool helps for understanding set of terms and definitions through gamification method. It's a gamification software. It's useful for learning activity. With this tool, most of the features are made available for free users, freely to use. There are few features are logged, kind of taking reports, kind of summary of our learners, grouping our learners, tracking the learning progress of our learners. These are all those options logged. Rest all made us free for the teachers community to make use of the benefit of Quizlet. Now, let us see the major features. Logging onto Quizlet is the first step. We can log in with either Gmail or ac.in or edu.in. ac.in, edu.in, these are all the two domains offered by Google for the educational community at a free of cost for using the Gmails and mailing options, how to use Quizlet, and creating a Quizlet study set, how to look at the existing study set also. There are two different ways we can make use of the Quizlet. Either we can pick up the existing study set, or we can create our own Quizlet study set. Using Quizlet flashcards, how to start learning, how to use learn feature, how to use spell feature, test feature, write feature, and setting the options for the test game. What are the options we can test for gamifications, and match feature, gravity feature, live feature. And there are two different study set we can pick and we can combine also. It is possible to combine study set of our own two different study set. Like for example, unit one, when we are teaching, we used to give unit one terms and definitions. When we move on to the unit two, we used to give unit two terms and definitions. Later part of the course, we can combine these two study sets together, or else one of the study set we can pick from the Quizlet existing study set, one we can create, those two study set also we can combine together. And combining many study sets also possible, revision and printing study sets also possible, deleting the study set is possible, creating classes. If we handle for computer science A section, third year B section, second year C section, something like that, we can create a class. Link to Quizlet diagrams. We can bring diagrams into Quizlet also. With the diagram and labeling, we can enable students to undergo or learn a study set. And creating the same Quizlet study set, we can link with the Google Classroom also. We can download the study set also. These are all the options available. Timing we can set, combining study sets we can do, scoring. Every individual learner can able to see the score, but as a teacher, we may not able to track those individual score. If it is licensed version, then it allows to take a report of students' study pattern. Again, we can type the word Quizlet in the Google search engine, then it will display the home URL of the Quizlet software. We can click this. The moment we click, it will take us to, it is logged in already, let me log out. Then from the beginning I will. This is the way it looks, the home page. Now we need to use this button, login. Click the login button, login with Google. I have all the three accounts, ac.in, edu.in, gmail.in. Whichever the way we want to use, we can use. So I'm going to log in with gmail.com. This is how the study set will look, or the home page will look. These are all the existing study set which I have incorporated in my previous way of discussion. Now let us see, top left corner, the search button is available. Using this search button, we can search for the study set which we require. Plenty of study sets available for geography, history, commerce, economics, science, physics, chemistry, biology, zoology, engineering, computer science, electronics and electrical engineering, management studies, mathematics also. If we are lucky, we will have existing study set for the topic which we are searching. If we are not, shortly we are going to discuss about how, being a teacher, we can create a study set by our own. With image, without image also, we can create a study set. Shortly we are going to look at that. Now, I'm going to type the keyword data science. A major topic I'm typing. Data science, enter. Just type the topic of interest which we are searching for and press the enter button. We will reach this page. Here, 44 terms data science, 76 terms, 133 terms. Whether we are searching for lesser number of terms and definitions or larger number of terms and definitions. If you scroll down, it will give all the reports, 100, 71. Surprisingly, 246 terms are available. So many more, much more than that, 247 also possible to get it. 247, 22, 247. And there are some more sets maybe available. We need to scroll. one of 22. So 20 pages of data science terms and definitions available. We can walk through whichever we like to administer to our student. Let us take for example this 44 terms, double click on it. Then it will take us to this page. On this page, this portion is important focus for learners. All the types of gamification, here 5 types of gamification, here 3 types of gamification techniques are available here. One after one, students can start going through whichever the style or the method suitable, they can adapt for their learning practices. This is the portion. If we scroll down after that study set, we can look at these 5 buttons. These are the 5 buttons. Teacher may need to use it for learning administration activities. So this portion or this focus is for only for teachers. This focus is for learner. Now let us see how each and every play option is helpful in learning. Anyone starts very first time that study set, need, it's my opinion to start with flashcard. So start with flashcard, double click. Now after reaching here, we need to focus on the bottom left hand side, in which option is the button we may need to focus. Why we need to focus, I will show you the demonstration. We need to click this options button. Initially, it is available with learning term first, subsequently definition, instead both. When we learn something, term and definition separately, that will be little bit tedious for brain to remember and memorize or understand. So that at a time, we need to look at both term and definition. So for that the option, we need to choose answer with both. Once it is selected, close this option tab. Now, if we look at, we can see term as well as the definition. Ordinary least square, OLS. What is the definition of OLS is given here. The mathematical equation. Mathematical equation is also given. So if we click this button, we can able to hear the audio note of that term also. Now, to move to the next, once we are thorough on the first term and definition, being a learner, need to press this next button. Gradient descent, what that means, definition, graphical representation. We can either go front or back using these two navigation buttons. At time during study set creation, if the teacher creates a study set with image, then with an image, we may not able to see these two buttons. It may be hidden. So by the time, we need to gently navigate to this button, keyboard shortcut. This is termed as keyboard shortcut. You just look at here, one keyboard is given. Click this keyboard, it teaches which is the shortcut key useful for which kind of navigation or operation with that slide. Term 1, definition 2, both 3, previous arrow mark, next arrow mark. These are all the arrow mark available on the keyboard. We can make use of that arrow mark for moving forward, and this is to move backward. Flip for space, flipping. So instead of term and definition, it will flip. Definition would go on the top, term would go come on the bottom. So shuffle, play, audio, zoom, image. Now, I will click the next button. So batch versus stochastic gradient descent, it shows. So difference between batch gradient descent and stochastic gradient descent. What is the definition? What are all the mathematical formulae for that? It is given. Now, I'm thorough on this. Now I want to move on to the next. Just I'm pressing. See, I'm not using this button or either this button. Now I'm going to press my keyboard arrow mark, right arrow mark, so that it's moving. Error matrices for linear regression. What are all the error matrices available? So this is how a student can learn using flashcard. So they need to go from beginning to the end. So this is how they can learn each and every term and definition and relevant stuff. Since it is a mathematical subject, it has mathematical equation also, English definition also, and all other representations, symbols, notations also available. So now, once if you are thorough on 44, either we can move towards 44 terms and definitions and we can thorough on it, then we can go back. If not, abruptly we can close. Now 30 terms, I'm going to close, back, click back. Next method, learn. Learn will give the option familiar, master, got it. So we need to click got it. So here it is giving the definition. We need to choose which is the best method of learning. Any key to continue. So it is giving the learning mode of accuracy versus baseline. This is the correct answer. It is testing our learning pattern. How do we understand? This is how it tests. It gives the entire definition and it tests with the term. We may need to choose the right term for the definition. That is learn mode. This is another method. Next, write. If you click write method, it suggests these three: binomial, nominal, ordinal. We may need to type answer for this question. So this is how it tests for writing mode. Next, spell. This spell, so it says it is telling that lasso regression. This audio note gives lasso regression. Then I need to type. Yes. It is moving to next. That is correct. So that it started moving to the next item. So this is how the spell. Auditory learners can make use of this. Next, test. This test will put in several mode. So it is asking with the fill in the blanks. What is this question? What is this question? And all of a sudden it comes to match the following. All of a sudden it comes to multiple choice. It will mix all the three. Fill in the blanks, match the following, and MCQ pattern. Multiple choice question, true or false. These are all the modality it will ask us to fill up or take part in the verification or in learning process. We need to click back. Then match. It's a kind of gamification. What? It's a pull and push. We may need to, it says start game. We may need to Bayesian inference. Which is the right answer? We need to find ridge regression. We need to find p-value. I'm clicking here. Yes, correct. Because of the correctness, it starts diminishing or vanishing. Ridge regression, error matrices for linear regression. How quick we are doing is also a matter. Bayesian inference, right? Log likelihood, right? Ridge regression is for penalty. Common error, RMSC. So everything is over. It won't, so among that all the player, I'm standing in the second position. So only for the learner, the score is possible to see. I am now second position. I can take a screenshot and I can send to my faculty. So that is how the evidences can be created. If you want the complete report, we may need to go for licensed version. So Enterprise Edition allows to take this report. So I have taken 33.1 seconds. So I am standing in the second place. Whereas there is one more person standing before me. So if I want to compete that person, I may need to play and again, and I need to practice. I need to increase the speed also and write also. One time I made wrong so that it is reducing the penalty. How quick we are answering and how correct we are answering. These are all the two thumb rule for deciding the ranking step. So this is how we can play. So next back. Next option is gravity. So what is that all about gravity? If you click gravity, start. This is how the gravity learning mode will appear. Get started. So we need to put answer with the term or definition. Definition is very tough. We need to write a lot. Also, it has a lot of mathematical equations. So better to put term. Then which level we want? Medium level, easy level. We need to keep easy level. Let's go. Show grading option is also available. Start game. So there is a ball will come with the definition. No multicollinearity, exogeneity, beta parameters, linear. Before this hitting this box, we may need to answer. Only then it will say right. If at all we are missing, it won't allow us to come out. Again and again, it will put us into the mode of learning. So these are all the way. Live is the game gamification mode useful for collaborative learning. These are all the seven methods useful for self-paced learning. The last one is useful for collaborative learning. That's it. So this is for meant for learner. Now coming to the teacher part. So this first plus button is useful for set to class or folder. We can create a class. First year CSE A section, second year CSE B section. We may handle two different sections. So which class this study set should go and be seated. So that we need to click this plus button to create a class or add to the class. Next is customize. Customize is the option useful for, although we picked the study set from the internet, some of the definitions we may not be appreciating, or some of the definitions may not be available in the syllabi, or some of the terms and definitions it may be missing what the teacher is expecting. So that we can remove the terms which are all we doesn't recover, we can include the terms which are all we recover. So for that, customize. Then the third button is share button. The share button is to share with our student. So whenever we decided to share with our student, after customizing also, or before customizing also, all the time this mode will be coming into the picture, then we need to click this. If you click this share button, this is the link for this study set. Whomever we are sharing, they all will be learner of this Quizlet study set. Normally, we tend to share with our closed circle of 60 students, 70 students. So this is how we can share. Or else, we can share in the Google Classroom also. Or just a copy link, then we can put it in the WhatsApp or Gmail or whichever the mode we want to communicate, that way we can communicate. The same copy link, we can go to Google Classroom. There also we can create a URL and we can create a post. Or directly if we click, it will take us to the Google Classroom directly. But for that, we may need to log in into Google Classroom before clicking this button. This is how we need to do. The next is info. It gives the basic information about this particular study set. How many classes are using this? How many folders it is available? How many learners are came across with this study set, that info detail. The last triple dot button is having, these are all the options, score, print. Score is locked mode, enterprise edition, we may not able to see. Print, we can download the study set in a paper. Combine, if you have multiple study sets, suppose you are looking at study set 1, study set 2, some 2-3 study sets you are picking from the internet, all those 3 study sets you want to combine also, you can combine. Or even want 2 different study sets also, you can combine. Or the study set which is picked from the internet and which we have created together also, we can combine. Export, this is to export in terms of PDF file, whatever. Embed, this kind of URL, if you want to embed in any kind of websites, we can embed. That's all. So report, something going against our policy, then we can report. Otherwise, we no need to use of report button. Now this is over. Now, there is an interesting way to earn money through Quizlet. I'll come later, or at the end of the video, I'll be demonstrating how we can be a partner with Quizlet in terms of earning money by creating premium quality study set, bestseller study set, something like that we are going to see. Now, customize. Let us consider existing study set. I want to customize this. Let me click this plus button. Now add to class. What are all the classes available? Add to class. Create a new class also. If at all first time, we can create a new class. CSE A section. I'm creating a CSE A section. A folder. Description. If you wish, we can give. Otherwise, we can give the same. We can give third year. Select a school. If you want school name, we can select, or we can type, or else not required. Create a class. You must provide a school name. Okay. It will use school name only, but we need to give our own institution name. B.V. Raj Institute of Technology, Narsapur, I'm giving, so that it's over. Create a class. Now all the necessary parameters are filled. Now it is creating CSE A section class. This is my first class available in the Quizlet dashboard. So if you look at the dashboard, we have got CSE A section. Within that, if you want, we can create folder. Now, right now, this class is sufficient. Now, what we are supposed to do? If we look at within CSE A section, I have brought one study set, that is data science. Now, let me click this. What I'm going to do, the very first button demonstration is over. Either we can create a folder or we can create a class for using this plus button. Now, the next button is termed as customize. using this only, we can remove unwanted terms and definitions, or we can rephrase, or we can change the existing definitions, and we can add our own definitions, whichever we want. Now we have come to this editing page, data science. Now I can give BDRIT, my own class, so that I can give CSEA section and customize it. The name of the study set itself we can change. Let's change it. This particular study set doesn't have any diagram to demonstrate, like body anatomy, entire body we can, the body picture we can upload, and we can label the organs. Or brain anatomy, we can bring the brain picture into it and we can label the anatomy parts. Or any block diagram we can bring and starts narrating the parts of the block diagram. I will show that also a little bit later. Right now, I'm coming back now. See, OLS, ordinary least squares, OLS distance. Here, method is linear regression for estimating the unknown parameters by creating a model which will minimize the sum of the squared errors between the observed data and the predicted data. So, either I can remove, it is, I can minimize, it is used to minimize the sum. This how we can modify also. I am not convinced with the definition which is given in the earlier, so I am changing the definition. Whereas gradient descent, I doesn't like the way they describe, or I am not at all introducing right now to my students. So just click the delete button, whichever we don't want. Similarly, the next batch versus stochastic gradient descent also I don't want. So I am clicking, deleting this. Whereas this I want to retain, it seems to be good. Okay, leave it. Now, p-value confidence interval. P-value confidence interval, there is no definition. If we want, we can include, or else we can delete. Similarly, the second one, if you want, we can retain, we can delete. The second one I want to delete. So deletion, I have shown sufficient amount of time, the demonstration. Suppose this one, how to determine if model is over or underfitted. Low train and test error metric. Train error metric is greater than test error metric. So if the same representation is used, load train train metrics must be less than. So the same representation if we give, students can able to understand better instead of confusing two different ways. So what we can do, train error metric should be less than test error metric. So its uniformity is maintained. So it seems to be good. Now this is how I can correct and I can customize. So if we don't want, we can delete. If you want either term part or definition part, we can correct it, delete it, so that we are coming down. So we started with 44 terms and definition. After several deletions, finally we end up with 38 cards. Now, we want to include our own term or definition. For that, add card. This button we need to click for adding as many cards we want. Statistics. So this is the definition, way of organizing and interpreting the data. Something like that I'm giving definition. Fine. Now let us see image. If we are lucky, it suggests some picture. Yes, we are lucky. So we can click this image for visual representation. Am I a learner, visual learner, auditory learner, sequential learner, reflective learner, kinesthetic learner? There are several types of learners exist. So it may be giving a lot of cues for learning, so that if it suggests picture, we are lucky. Otherwise, we cannot upload our picture. Being a free user, we are not permitted to upload our own image. The moment I click upload, it starts telling, try it free trial. Yeah, lucky. It allows to upload. So it is asking to pay the card detail, then it allows to use it. If you are not interested to fill out the card details also, or not ready to pay also, it's a very nominal charge only, $3 per month, $5 per month, very nominal charge. If you are not interested, we no need to go. If automatically it recommends, only then we can make use of that image. Otherwise, not possible. For example, here I am going to give the definition for right skewed. tail at the right end of the distribution curve. Something like that I'm giving. I'm typing, or else we can copy paste. If we have the appropriate definition either from the internet or our e-material, we can copy paste. Now let me click this image. If yeah, we are lucky. It is giving right skew. So this is right skew, right end tail. This is left skew. So here we can understand mode is greater than median. Median is greater than mean. So this is how we may need to include the definitions, terms, whatever we want to include. Now I don't want to include anymore. So now we have discussed how to include a new card and how to correct the existing card and how to delete the existing card. All those three things over. Now we need to press the button, create button. If we look at the create button is available on the top also. Also it is available on the bottom. Either way we can click the button create. Now it is customized. Although we picked from the internet, we start the same copy link only. Now this URL will be same as long as how many times we want to correct also, it doesn't matter. It remains to be same. We can keep on correcting or doing changes, modifications, adding cards, removing cards, anytime, any number of times we can do. So now copy link over. Now one study set we have created with the class third CSEA section. Now we need to click this to go to the particular study set. We started with the 44 terms. Again, we ended with 44 terms. It's available here. Now, because of new inclusions. So we can go to sets. That set shows all the available study sets. 40 study set, 5 terms, 4 terms. Now, class, this is over. We can search any topic. For example, body anatomy or brain anatomy. Body anatomy, I am typing. Geography also you can put. India map, world map, Italy map, any country map you can put. Now I'm coming here. Body anatomy, it is giving chemistry of the human body, it is telling. And the physiology guide, it is telling. Bestseller. The moment we see bestseller, we cannot use. We may need to pay to administer the study set or to loan also. Similarly, premium also, it won't allow us to use. Reuse is not possible. Even use is also not possible. Whichever is not labeled with 156 terms available, anatomy, body anatomy is available, but neither it is premium nor it is bestseller. Now we can make use of it. Double click. Now we need to go to first type. So this is for administering to the students or customizing or creating a folder. To study this study set, click the flashcard. After clicking the flashcard, we need to change the option. Option instead of term. By default, it will be term. So we need to convert it into both. Only then, anatomical position, it starts explaining. Next. Next, we can keep moving on. Sometimes, why this made it as free is, there is no picture, no visual cue for learning. That is why it is free. Absolutely, we understand. We can understand easily by looking at the, so yeah, it has come. The moment the picture has come, you can't see this arrow sometimes. Sometimes you may see. If this arrow is not visible, no need to become panic. We can use the keyboard, arrow key. This arrow key I'm using right now, so that it starts moving. So this is how it works. Now I'm going to search next one. India map. Enter. History teachers, anyone can make use of this India map. So 14 terms available, so that it teaches only 14 states or 14 locations. We don't know. 23 terms, 21 terms or 45 terms. Click this 45 terms. No premium, no bestseller. We can make use of it. So double click flashcard. All the games, but first we need to start with flashcard. First we need to learn, read it, so that it will work. Options, within the option, both. Only then learning would become better. So that it shows in the globe map where India is located. Next Pakistan, next Afghanistan. Although I have put India map, it's showing world map. So then we need to be careful. Before administering to a student, we need to walk through what changes we need to give. Tibet and Nepal, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, it starts showing the neighborhood countries, and the states of India also. So this is how we need to use. Once if it is done, let us go back. Now, how to make use of the existing, again, Quizlet. Quizlet, if we click, whenever we click, it will take us to the dashboard, the complete summarization of the Quizlet. Now, we, so far now we have seen how to make use of the existing study set. Right now, I'm going to demonstrate without looking into the existing study set. Sometime, if we are unfortunate, study set may not be available for our desired topic. So by that situation, what we need to do? There is no other goal. We need to create our own study set. So that we need to click create. I'm creating, try it for free. So nothing to worry, just close this button, over. Now, demonstration or demo study set. I'm giving the study set name. If you want a description, we can give. For video recording, I'm giving a description because there is no purpose for me. Now, first I'll start with study set demonstration with labels and diagram. So how I'm going to do? Click this, chatbot theory. There are few images already available. I can make use of that. So this is the image I'm bringing here. It's getting loaded. Yes, over. Now I can label it and I can start explaining, or I can change the image also. Now what we are going to do is label this one. Something here I'm going to put. These are all the chat role of chatbot. So what I'm going to give is compliance, mode of compliance. Mode of compliance, add definitions. Customer care, customer care services, receives complaints from the customer in different modes. What are all those modes? Mail, call, customer desk, mobile app, chatbot, social media, other mode also may be available. So after this, we should click add. This is label. This label we created for this block diagram. So let us scroll down. See, where I started typing is available here. So later on also you can change, nothing to worry. Now I'm going to label another part here. This is corpus of text. Corpus. So definition. Collection of text information, corpus. So add something like this, you can label, add label. So the role of chatbot, chatbot, that portion is role of chatbot. So does, I can write also here, I can copy paste, it does categorization, channeling, automation, service, this all I can write also. Over. Now using this diagram, I started creating three terms and three definitions. No need to constrain with the diagram itself. We can mix and match also. With the diagram, we started creating these three. Without diagram also, I can do something. For example, I'm typing here etymology. This is a word. If I click here, I'm lucky. The definition is also suggested automatically. The study of the origin of words and the way in which their meaning have changed. I'm choosing this. Fine. If I want to put capital T, I can put. Or further, I want to add something, root of the word. So root of the word, something like that, I'm including. Anything if you wish, we can include. Click image. If you are lucky, it will give. Otherwise, see, very beautiful image it gives. Root of the word. So this appreciating image also we will get. So this kind you can create. So sometime there will not be any images, definitions. Automatically it won't suggest. By that situation, we need to type and we need to copy paste from the material which we have prepared or from the internet which we have identified. Curated content we can give. Similarly, image, if it is suggest, we are lucky, we can make use of it. If not, we cannot upload, being a free user. For the enterprise edition, it allows to upload as much as images we want, add card. The second word which we want to type here is ICT. I'm typing ICT. So if we come here, information and communication technology, it is suggest easy. I'm clicking that. So no worries for me. I'm clicking image. It suggests these four images for ICT. Whichever I like, I can make use of this. This I'm using. Over. This is how, see, a school subject that deals with computer, use of technology for the input output, further enriched definition it starts giving, because it starts understanding the context of the image selection. How I'm selecting the image, depending upon it, it starts giving further recommendation. This is how Quizlet works. Now, we started a fresh study set, given the title, given the description, uploaded the image, labeled. Rest of other part we no need to use, that will not be helpful for us most of the time. This is paint, just to adjust the image, that's all. This is for upgrade to add the rectangle. So this is also not useful for upgrade feature. So this round color option, add label, that part of the block diagram we started explaining. For the first label, if you click, it shows mode of complaints. These are all the complaints, customer care receipts. Next button, if I click, it shows corpus, definition, information, there is a spelling mistake. I can correct either here, or you can go to here, and here itself we can correct. Collection of text information, full stop also I can give. Or else, just close this. Let us see. Now, is there any? Yeah, it is recommending. Corpus Shakespeare works, general collection of body of writings laws, a body of collection of writings to structure of a special character in a animal body, in an animal body, it is giving. So it's not required. So I'm not convinced with the definition which is recommended by this. So that what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete and I'm going to use my own definition. Collection of text information. So for that, let me click. Is there any, no, corpus. This shows brain organ, corpus, collapsum. So doesn't suit. So I no need to use. So it won't, it will not get reflected. Everything is over. As many as cards we want, we can keep on adding this add card. Everything is over. Create, modification, things are over. Create. There is no limit. It allows. Now, the link has come. Copy link. We can share with our students. Now, further in future also, let us come back to Quizlet. I'm signing off right now. Imagine, after a couple of days, I want to do editing. I want to add many more. Yes, demo study set. I have put demo study set. There is a mistake. So still there is a scope to edit. Edit second one. For our own study set, it won't to show demo. Demo study set, typo error. For our own study set, it won't show customize. It will show edit. When we use the existing study set, it shows customize. When we use our own study set again and again repeatedly, then it shows edit. But that button, arrow mark, edit button, pen button is same. Arrow mark is for share. So now again, we can come back and revisit and do the changes, necessary changes if required. Otherwise, we can use done. Click the Quizlet, we can go back to that particular place. Now, the same demo study set I wanted to bring into the class. Now, what I can do, add the study set, add to class, section A. I need to choose this. So, once if it is chosen, it goes to that study set. Otherwise, we can create a new study, class or folder. Once these things are over, what we are going to look at, Quizlet. There is an exciting part of discussion. Teachers, click this teachers. Here we could see a lot of articles related to this Quizlet. Presentation templates, become a power teacher, need help getting started. These are all the like manual, track student progress, these all. We can read a lot of stuff within the Quizlet itself. Day by day, they may be upgrading. If not a couple of months together, they will upgrade a lot of features. Then they will come out with the success stories and how to administer the learning philosophy, teaching philosophy behind of this tool. A lot of articles they will be sharing. Now there is an exciting feature, partnership. We can become partner with Quizlet. Let me click on this. See, it has social science material, other science, maths, language, arts, and humanities, Quizlet Live, Quizlet Learn, diagrams, flashcard. I will show other features also. Diagrams, flashcard, mobile, honor code. These all you can read and you can go through, whichever are available. Now let us come back to this. Partner with Quizlet. Become a Quizlet verified creator and combine your content with Quizlet's fun and engaging tool. We can create something, a better content, unique content, which is not available on the topic. We can identify trendy topic or anything, whichever or which country Quizlet is using more, for which domain Quizlet is using more. That kind of statistics, if we come to know on that particular topic and domain, we can create a study set. We may be creating, monetize your content. We may create a study set once in a time, but throughout it will bring fetch earning, a good amount of earning for that study set. The premium content, if the quality is too good, you can go for premium content and bestseller content also. So this is a Quizlet. Quizlet's 50 a monthly users, 50 million users are available across the globe. So that content, through the content creation, we can monetize for the good amount of earning. So this is the end tip I wanted to end with. So study set, whichever we create for the global notice, that all will create a lot of money. With that, I end this video demonstration. Thank you for watching. Keep watching. Please share this material in your circle and in your friend circle and academic circle. Thank you all.